Hey y'all, welcome back. As you can see, we have the 2022 Zamac set in front of us. I'm going to try to finish wrapping up this 2022 factory sealed set that we've been working on. Still have the Zamacs, the Red Edition, Treasure Hunts, and the store exclusive. So I'm just going to try to probably do a short video for each of those. That way it's a little bit easier to find what you're looking for. But I don't want to glaze over it because I know a lot of you had commented and sent me messages wanting to take a closer look at some of these things. So it's getting a little late in the year for 2022 stuff, but you know, obviously there's still a little interest in it, and there's still some 2022 stuff rolling into stores in some places. So I know some of these are things a lot of you guys haven't been able to see in the wild, and you know, a lot of you don't have some of these stores near you, so I know you may not get to see them at all unless you order them online. So let's just go ahead and get into it here. The Zamacs for 2022 had 18 cars, I believe it was. Yes, 18 cars. I had heard that they're going to make less in 2023, but I have not seen that confirmed, and I'm not sure how many it was supposed to be. I read somewhere there was a rumor that they were going to do less. So if I see that posted for real somewhere, I'll try to let everybody know. So the first one we have here is the 19 Mercedes-Benz A-Class. Pretty neat looking car, nice with the stripe. The Zamacs, guys, if you don't know, that's just an acronym for the materials that Hot Wheels are made out of. These are Walmart exclusives, and they basically are just a raw car with no paint. They do still have the tampos and some of the like detail paint, the stuff that's on the wheels, the different color, but the body itself will not be painted. So and honestly, for some of these cars, I know Zamacs aren't usually as popular, or at least they haven't been the past few years as popular as the Red Editions. But for some of these, I think this is the best looking casting they had this year. So, and this is probably one of those, actually. Number two here is the 20 Jeep Gladiator. And I didn't mention it, but all of these have a regular mainline version. They're just a different color, basically, than the mainline releases. Have the Mazda Repu here. To admit, I'm not just a super huge fan of this truck, but it looks pretty good as a Zamac. Again, another one I think looks really good in this raw is the Nissan R390 GTI. Probably one of my personal favorites is the 69 Copo Camaro here, or sorry, Copo Corvette. I don't know what it is. I think the blue to me just seems to really go good on the Zamacs. It just kind of pops against them better than a lot of other colors. We have number six, the Big Air Bel Air. Do kind of like the to me this is more of a fantasy casting. I know it's a Bel Air, and yeah, somebody could do it like this, but you know, I think a lot of people consider this a fantasy casting. I kind of like the orange interior here. I think it really looks good against the silver, so the raw, whatever you want to call it. I'm gonna call it silver. It's a pretty cool color combination. Have the Ford Mustang Mach-E 1400, and I think this was the best looking version of this casting. The other colorations I can kind of care less about, but this one I thought was pretty cool. Do wish they'd have done something a little different with the tint on the window, but it is what it is. Have the 71 Dodge Charger. The Bone Shaker looked good. Again, to me, it's just personal preference, but I thought the blue looked pretty good against the raw body there. And to be honest with you, we're kind of bone shaker fans in this house. This is probably, I'm going to say, the most popular, or at least one of the most popular Zamacs we had this year, Honda S2000. I think this looks good. I really wish they'd have done something beside these yellow wheels on it. I think they kind of stick out a little bit, because the rest of the car looks really good, and to me, this just doesn't look like it belongs. I would have preferred them just to do plain black wheels other than this. I'm sure there's some other things they could have done, but I don't know. Just the large yellow portion just didn't really do it for me. I do, however, like the wheels on this, the Alfa Romeo BC Competizione. Yes, I'm sure my slang, my southern draw really makes that Competizione sound really good. So, there, get you a good chuckle. But this was a pretty cool looking car. I thought the other colors, I can't remember, I know they did a red, but this looked good here. This almost reminds me of like a Pontiac Solstice. Is that what those were called? Can't remember. I think it was a Pontiac Solstice, and then Saturn maybe had a car just like it. Yeah. Anyway, not a bad looking casting. Have the Volkswagen Baja Bug. Again, I think this one looks pretty good in it too. Batmobile was pretty cool. I'll have to admit though, I think of all the colors they did of this, I like the gunmetal gray they did, but I actually think the green one ended up being my favorite. But this is still a pretty cool Zamac. I like it. Once again with the blue GTO. I just think that pops pretty well. I don't even mind the blue wheels on this one. I think they go pretty well. '68 El Camino. I did like this one. It's pretty cool. They got the patina on here. Something a little different. I actually think this was my favorite version of this casting too. I don't know, just something about it. It kind of pops. And I think the tampos really look good on it. They're not like just crazy. They're kind of subtle, but it all kind of blends in together. Have the 84 Audi Sport Quattro. Another one that I really liked. Just for some reason, I think this casting looks good in it. And the tampos look really good against that. And the wheel choice I thought was good. Wheel and color choice went well with that. Dodge Viper RT10. This one was fairly popular. Of course, it's a Viper, so, you know, it's going to have a little bit of a following. There's just something about this one that doesn't really appeal to me. And I can't quite put my finger on it. I do like Vipers. It's kind of like the Shelby Cobras. Sometimes there's just a casting of them that I'm just really not crazy about. And I love the cars. It's just, I don't know. I guess we all have our little preferences, but that one just I wasn't crazy about in the Zamac. Now this one I did like, and this is the last one, the 69 Camaro convertible. I thought this was a really good looking color on it. Simple convertible looks nice, and the black looks good against it. Everything was just kind of nicely, I guess, tastefully done, you could say, on this. So. Overall, I thought, I know it seemed like a lot of people were disappointed with the Zamacs this year, and I have a feeling that was kind of because of the lack of JDM, square body. It was the casting selection, and I kind of get that. I probably have a little bit different taste than a lot of the other collectors these days, so... I understand what people like. It's just not usually the same thing that I would be into, even though I can appreciate it. But I have a few here that I really like. There's some that I could have, I could take or leave. But overall, I think it's a nice mixture, at least. probably touches a little bit on what everybody likes. At least one or two castings. So hopefully you found something in here that you liked. Let's see. I guess that's about all I have for it, guys. So thank you for watching this far, if you're still with us. If you like what we're doing, give us a like and subscribe. Look out for the other videos for the store exclusives we'll be coming out with. I'll try to put those out here in the next couple days, just kind of get this case or this set wrapped up. So appreciate y'all. Hope everybody's having a good week, and happy hunting, y'all.